Alexander.
Wow, the Battle of Marrakesh ends in a stalemate as Nigeria lost to Mali last night, 2-0. It was a nice outing for the boys. A new coach, new set of players. But before I continue, this is Final Whistle, where we'll bring to you football at its raw form, you know? The street vibes, the pure analysis, fans' reactions, transfer news, and everything pertaining to football. Today, we'll be discussing about the Super Eagles outing with against Mali last night. What does this Nigerian fan feel about it? What was Finidi George's, you know, performance in the game with the crop of players he had? Welcome, Ola.
Shalom, good morning.
Good morning, brother.
How are you doing now?
Fine. How did you see the game overall? How do you see the game?
Let me first make this clear. I think Finidi George thinks he has the job already. He should know that these games that are given to him is like an interview process.
Yeah.
And if you ask me, so far, he's not impressing. You understand? Just imagine I'm the person interviewing him now, and you give me a performance against Ghana. A Ghana without Kudus. You want 2-1, well, a win is a win. Then you win, you allow Mali win you 2-0, even without some of their key players. You understand? I will understand that Nigeria too are missing stars.
Exactly what I wanted to tell you,
you
now.
Understand? But I think that is no excuse, because if you look at the potential he still had in that squad yesterday, I was expecting him to win comfortably. But be as it be, I don't understand what he was trying to do yesterday. I understand it was part of the backroom staff of Pasero. So maybe that's the reason why he was using the five-man defense yesterday against the Malian side, that we only know them for their physicality, not because they can come outside and play.
Yes.
We know them for their set piece, not because they can come out and play. Then you're using a five-man defense. I don't understand. And this five-man defense are not even your first choices if you have a serious match.
So that means you can cut him some slack now if you know that the five-man defense is not his first choice. We have a lot of injuries in that back line.
I understand, but if you look at the bench yesterday, you understand, some players that he actually started against Ghana was on the bench yesterday, which I understand is an experiment.
It's an experiment, exactly.
But that's what I'm saying. As a coach, you understand, first half, you can see how the game is unfolding. You can make one or two changes. Change the formation at least. Using a five-man defense that are not even comfortable of bringing out the ball. You know, this five-man defense is an Italian formation.
Yes.
It was synonymous to Antonio Conte
yes.
And the rest. And in Italy, defense is an art. They are proud of defenders being you know what I'm saying,
the likes of Cellini, Bonucci and all that.
Even
Bazagli,
exactly what I'm saying, Bazagli, the rest. So these players are also comfortable on the ball. If you look at the first goal, where a right back is a center back from this side, because you're playing a three, I don't know why it was him. I was trying to load the ball back to his central defender when you can actually easily clear it to Osayi, your right back, or you clear it to Troy or do something. Then you give him a chip goal where the other players, midfielders, were expecting the ball. You understand? And that five-man defense, you need rugged midfielders. We know Ndidi is just coming back from injury. You understand? So I'll cut him some slack, because Ndidi's physicality. We also miss Onyeka in that midfield. You know, Onyeka is up and running. It's like a typical box-to-box midfield.
Yeah.
Onyeka reminds me of Ramirez in Chelsea.
Can
do the attacking play.
And he can return back.
Yes, and do the dirty job. Football, you must not do it every time pretty. There are some players that they are not known for their skills, but they do the basics. You understand? So I think the goals we considered was as a result of one or two mistakes on the defenders. You understand? And aside from the defenders, I think the Malian side ethos set piece. For every corner, they are winning the first ball and the second ball. Imagine how was all in that goalkeeper post. You know, because they were winning the first ball and the second ball.
Yes.
Even the physicality we're expecting them to put in yesterday was not even happening. They came to play when they scored the first goal. You understand? That defense line, I didn't know what was going on. Then it would be you using it would be in a more slightly way. Pasero was using Iwobi. We saw what you did against Ghana now. We're applauding Iwobi. No, maybe because he saw that we're applauding Iwobi, not him. Maybe that's why he reverted back. Because Iwobi played well against Ghana because of where he played. We see Iwobi play against where Fulham. Makes assists, score goals. They respect him in London. Those Inid boys, they call them Inid boys. You understand? So he played a bit like this. You started a match without a recognized striker. Imagine. A call-up that you invited Umar Sadiq. You invited Terry Murphy. You invited
Nathan Teller.
Then you now started that same match without a recognized striker. It had to take 32 minutes of play that Moses Simon was injured
before you now bring Dresser.
You understand? Even Dresser has missed a 1-on-1. I would understand. That's a striker for you. Chances come, You understand? Next time you bring your head down and try to convert. You understand? My aim is I don't understand why you're using a 5-man defense, a 3 midfielder that is not attacking midfielder, and they are all basically defensive midfielders. You understand? Then using no recognized striker in Moses Simon and Iheanacho. And mind you, if you are playing 5 defense, there are times that the defender needs to load the ball for your recognized striker to hold up play, to hold the ball. Iheanacho is not that man. Moses Simon is not that man. They prefer to have the ball at their feet. So what are we saying? What was he trying to do yesterday? As I say, if it is me that was interviewing yesterday, to me it's like, young man, are you sure you want this job? You understand?
So
I think the Malian side, kudos to them. They came outside, they brought a different dynamics to play. We're expecting to be physical, you understand? But they came outside, they played, and they played friendly well.
Do you think this whole reaction is coming from a place where you thought we were going to whitewash these guys? You know, everybody had that mindset that the Eagles of Mali are a small team. But remember, their performance in the last AFCON was impressive, you know? They reached the quarterfinals of the AFCON. So these guys are not a soft opponent to think you're going to walk over them. With your second 11, if I may say, you know? This is now our first 11.
No, I won't say that. So, I won't say that. You know when we were supposed to play Argentina in the friendlies, aspiration to the World Cup qualifiers and everything, and people were saying, okay, we are going for a cheaper opponent. I was like telling them, you don't know this Malian side. They're a worldly opponent. Ghana were a worldly side to play as preparatory for any kind of competition you're going into. That's what I was saying, that you are not supposed to be using some kind of, sometimes I even understand why sometimes coaches bench some kind of players, or they just do some kind of call up to make up the numbers. What is Owazem thinking? Owazem has been in Eagles this thing since I can remember.
This is second World Cup.
He has been going. So I don't understand what is he doing? The brightest player on that pitch yesterday was easily Nwabali. And Nwabali, I think he's as usual now. We know that if he's there, we give his best.
Yeah.
You understand? So I don't understand. Yesterday we were just lackluster. We had to start resorting from playing shots from outside because there was no connection.
Exactly. Yeah.
I can't see Nigeria making 5 passes from the defense to the midfield to the distance. And in the AFCON, if I should remind you, that defense actually took us to the final. That was the one named Ekong, the player of the tournament, because our defense was solid with the Bassis, with the Ekong, with the Ajayi.
Yeah.
We'll see our defense yesterday. Against a second team Malian. So if you say we're a second team yesterday, them two didn't start their best players. They're missing like 3-4 notable players.
True.
You understand?
True.
And they humbled us. There was no fight in that team yesterday. I don't understand why. Maybe because they were fearful of injury or some kind of things. I don't understand. But I think if any the judge needs to carve out his own philosophy. Because to me, I think he's doing copy and paste from Passero's
playbook.
So he needs to work on the set piece.
Yeah.
On the set piece. Because you can't have a team with the height of Ajayi, with the height of all those Awazen, the rest, and they'll play a set piece. The opposition will play a set piece. They'll win the first ball and the second ball. It's wrong.
Yes.
If they win the first ball, because I would understand, the second ball is your player should be able to clear. You understand? True. That's what killed us yesterday. That match could have easily gone 4-5-0 because of their set piece. You understand? Possession-wise, they were even there. They had even more clear possessions than us because the possession was like 50-50. But position wise, they had more clear chances. And also, we had to resort to long ball, started playing shots from outside 18. Iheanacho started playing shots from outside. I can't remember that much that I watched. Iheanacho playing shots from inside the 18-yard box. It was outside. The only clear cut chances was that dresser when he came in
one on one
that he missed. It wasn't even on target. Skyrocketed over the bar. You understand?
Some things are like that.
I understand. But Finidi George needs to go back up. That he should remember that this job is not his own. Interim tomorrow night, they can say, young man, you're not there.
It will be like another Iguavan to him.
Exactly the point. We say your name go the paper. You will go there, you know your name know the list again. So I think he needs to sit down. Okay, the international break is over now. He needs to sit down, work on the players, scout more players. You understand? Home base. If it is a match you want to do experiment, why don't you give the home base players a chance?
Talking about that, you know he wasn't the one that did the call up.
Okay.
So you can cut him some slack on that.
He wasn't the one that did the call up.
No. As at the time the call up was out, we had Iguavan as the interim manager. So that was why, you know, earlier a lot of fans were reacting to the call up and everything. I'm like, don't blame Finidi for whatever performance comes out of this friendlies, you know. He was not there. He's just there to manage the players.
Okay. I understand what you're trying to say. Since we can't actually attribute more blame to him for yesterday's loss, but we should give him credit for a Ghana win, but you understand? he's still football. You know, at least he won one.
Lost one, exactly.
My only problem is how he lost yesterday. But I think going forward now, he will be the interim manager, you understand? So since he's part of the managers in the NPF, I feel he should go down to the MPF and scout two or three players at least to make his name, because that seat, me and you know, that is come and go. Yeah. You understand? Like Soja. Soja go, Soja come.
Barak, remember the same.
This is time. Let him use it well. So I will remember for something nice. So that's all I can say. And yeah, I wish him the best of life. I really wish him well. Let him do well. If not, I know they will be, you will hear me and you go there now. And that person go
there. Thank you very much. Right, thank you, Ola. Thank you. Wow. He wishes Philippe George all the best in his career. You know, we want him to be the manager. We've seen what he has done so far. A win against Ghana that we haven't done in quite a number of years. In fact, they were the ones that hindered us going to the World Cup in Qatar 2022. So, Finidi did it for us. He lost one against Mali, but we are positive that he's going to do the job. We hope NFF is going to give him the opportunity to do the job. Thank you, guys. Be with us next time. Like, comment, subscribe. See you. Gracias.